We are on our way to the campsite. I got a good night's rest. Chess has been a little irritated the last 2 or 3 days after doing a little work on the other van. We got the battery charger with us. We're gonna put it on for a few hours and see if maybe we can get this van started. Probably won't try to start today, just so to get a real good charge. Overall, I don't feel too bad. I think today is November the 28th. One thing we're gonna check is I heard that one of the common problems that these Ford Econo lines don't start is the ground wire on the frame becomes loose. And it's over here somewhere. And it looks like it is fine. I can't really tell. I have to look back on the camera, but see, I have to get no look, no position, but underneath it's pretty clean. I've been doing this life bullshit for 30 years. And even though 20 years of asthma, 2 years of mast cell activation syndrome and multiple chemical sensitivity and 13 different food allergies, 2 stomach surgeries, losing 50 pounds, and all the other number of different things, delayed gastric emptying on my stomach, there's too many things to list. I'm still out here, by the grace of God, out here every day doing what I can do to make my situation better. And a lot of people at this point would have done give up. I also have the mold illness. I just found out I got chronic Lyme. And I am so lucky and so blessed that I can still do what I can do, and that can change tomorrow. And I'm telling you from personal experience, I don't think the next 30 years will get much better. It just makes you a stronger person. But you gotta keep on keeping on, and that's the whole point of this, the whole point of these videos is I've lost home. We got a Flagstaff camper where I didn't work because I had mold. Now we're doing the van ordeal. And my biggest lesson that I think I like to teach people is do what you can do. That's all you can do. And, you know, I had to give up a job making $40,000 a year. And a mobile home that I just remodeled, I've said it a million times, but you just do what you can do. Got the battery charger on van number one. Looks like pretty good ways. Got my hot water heater insulated. Give it a check. It's coming on up.
we have life.
Another tip I want to tell y'all is the reason I'm opening the door up before I rerun the ozone generator is, according to the booklet and the research that I've done, ozone generators tend to work the best in colder, dry climates. It's 38 degrees today, so I opened up the door. And as you may know, a lot of times in cold weather, the air is drier, the humidity is lower. That's why mold has a hard time growing in the wintertime. So I'm letting all that cold air pipe into that, or pull into that camper, since the wind's so terrible today. We got 20, 30 mile an hour gusts, sometimes higher. So all that cold air is getting pushed into the living space, and that'll bring the humidity down. And when I go to start it back up, hopefully that'll help that ozone generator do what it needs to do, if it's even any chance at all of it working. So that's kind of my thinking on that.
I made that quick. Now we're gonna shut this. It's been airing out for about 2 or 3 hours. I got my respirator on, got my face covered up. I'm gonna hold my breath in there as I turn it on. So I'm gonna run in and run right back out, so that way hopefully I'm not doing any more damage to myself. And then it's gonna sit for hopefully a good 3, 4, or 5 days or whatever before I even open the window. That way it gets a good dose of ozone. So I'm gonna hold my breath, run in there, move it where I need to move it.
I've always been mostly a loner, even before multiple chemical sensitivity. So the loneliness really doesn't bother me. I was growing up, I didn't party a whole lot.
I was all the time doing some kind of project, fixing something, repairing something, covering grease, covering oil. It was all the time. I was buying an old car, fixing it up. So I didn't have time, and with all the overtime that I worked, and then buying a home and redoing it, I had a mother was diagnosed with cancer 2013. My grandmother was diagnosed 2012, so I helped take care of her a whole lot. And when my mother was diagnosed, I had to step up and help. And then on her last treatment, my father was diagnosed, and I helped him with his therapies and his appointments and stuff. So I went 5 years without a vacation day. All my vacation days went toward his care and his well-being. And then I bought a, like I said, I bought a home on top of it. So I was redoing it on my days off. I was working overtime to have the money to redo the home, even though it wasn't the prettiest looking setup or the best looking setup. But I was determined I was gonna have a house before I was 30 years old. And that's the whole reason why I have MCS, is because I pushed myself so hard in my regular or my normal life. I never had fun with anything. And a lot of people that, you know, that's that driven OCD, usually they end up, they do really, really well for a long time, and they just, their body just hits a point and they just fall apart. And that's basically what happened with me, is because I already had underlying conditions, Lyme disease, et cetera, then I started getting all the co-infections. All these things started adding up, and then when I got sick, it was just full-blown, wide open. So it's lesson to the wise: don't overdo it, because you only, your body wears out just like a car. So I'm never saying never. I get what I want, so they call me go-getter. Yeah, I know he does it good, but you know I do it better. So misunderstood, if she wanted, then I let her. Everybody knows if I want her, then I get her. She gave me that look, yeah, she knows she thinks I'm clever. I don't think I do it good, no, I think I do it great. They would do it if they could, they can't do it, so they ain't. Everybody wanna look.
Take.
And there's your mold on the back side of that insulation. Well, I have some good news. This is inside of van number 2. And it actually smells really good. I hadn't even pressure washed it yet. Smells really good. It really, really does. I think van 2's gonna work, thank God. So here's what we done. We jacked up the front a little bit, and I lowered the air pressure in the tires. That way it makes a little gray, and we put some towels here. That way when I start pressure washing, hopefully the water doesn't run back up under the insulation, because the last thing we want is mold. So we've got some towels here. So we should be good to go to pressure wash. Our towels work. What the goal was to keep from the water traveling back after pressure washing. We can see that the insulation is completely dry. I'm gonna double check it, because we don't want no mold forming. It is dry as a bone. Even back here, dry as a bone. So we're good to go. So give her a good wipe down, should be good. Check it out. get her done. Sensitivity community and my Lyme's community, which I'm all part of, mold illness. Got a whole lot done today. My neighbor came out west and got the first van stripped out. They got the seats, seat covers, all that, got it out. Van too, I got it pretty well cleaned, the back of it. Got my car washed, pressure washer was a big help. Absolutely wore out, put in all day. Just a great day overall. I'm so glad that so far I haven't had a reaction. So a big shout out to my neighbor for helping, and a big shout out for, or a big thank you to the Lord for letting me being able to come out and being able to do this. I'm about ready to pack everything up. I'm letting I got the doors and stuff open on the van, so that way no condensation forms in there, eliminates mold. So I'm getting ready to pack up, get me a bite, hadn't even stopped to eat. So, God bless. I do what I want, so I'm never saying never. I get what I want, so they call me go-getter. Yeah, I know he does it good, but you know I do it better. So misunderstood, if she want it, then I let her. Everybody knows, if I want her, then I get her. She gave me that look, yeah, she knows she thinks I'm clever. I don't think I do it good, no, I think I do it great. They would do it if they could, they can't do it, so they hate. Everybody wanna look, but nobody wanna play. Stealing eyes like a crook, while I put it on display. I don't do it by the book, no, I do my own thing. That's why every single hook got him singing like me. And I ain't in any rush, cause I'm finally getting paid. Don't believe in any luck, I believe I'm self-made, yeah. The van stuff out of the way. We got a lot of the van one ripped out. Van two is pretty well clean, so hopefully be able to move in it here pretty soon. I wanted to touch base on a few things. As you may know from my previous videos, if you haven't checked them out, please give those a look, because all this is important information for multiple chemical sensitivity. I feel like
I've been doing heavy metal EDTA chelation, and what that is, it helps you flush out heavy metals. And currently waiting on the results of my hair analysis test. Usually it takes about 4 weeks. So I apologize, I won't be able to go over that in the video. But what I do have is, with heavy metal chelation, as many of y'all know, it flushes the good out and it flushes the bad out. So it's important to have your mineral levels checked. So I have a pretty interesting test lined up. It is, it's a 24-hour urine. And since I've been doing chelation for roughly about three weeks, I think I've took a total of about 15 to 17 tablets. And it's got it has instructions with it. And what we're going to do is this urine test or urine analysis, the purpose of it is to check my heavy metals that I'm flushing. So when I get the test results of that, that'll be very interesting. That'll tell me what heavy metals I'm flushing out as I'm chelating, and we'll see which ones, because a lot of times when you get a heavy metal poison, unless it's an acute poison, if it's a long-term low exposure, it's locked in tissues and it doesn't show up in urine very well, and it doesn't show up in blood very well. But when you chelate, you're doing a process called provocation, which is you're provoking or you're encouraging these heavy metals to leave your body. So the purpose of this urine analysis test that I requested from my PCP is, since I've been doing a chelation, we can look at the results when I get them. And when I get those results, it'll tell us what I'm flushing out, what our problem areas are, and it'll give us a good idea of a lot of the issues that I've had and I've been having. So I figured I'd add that in a video. That way people can use it as a tool for something that they may look into with their MCS, and seeing that I am improving and I am doing better. So hopefully we'll just keep staying on the right track. Supplements and everything's the same. So I look forward to seeing y'all on the next episode. Hopefully get moved in this van. Heavy metal hair analysis test results, we'll go over it, and we'll go over the urine analysis test and see what heavy metals I've flushed now since starting the chelation test. America, open your dining rooms. Seriously. But have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas. And when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Oh, hold the mistletoe. I'm where you can't. I hope you will. If you like the video, please give it a like, share, and subscribe. I just started a Facebook page. It's called Multiple Chemical Sensitivity, The Search for the Cure. If you enjoyed the content, please join that group, and let's all get together and be a part of the fight. And that way we all can hopefully get well and heal. Thank you, and God bless.